Well, as the new school year begins, many of us are posting happy snaps of our kids heading back to the classroom. But this year, the AFP is urging parents to take privacy precautions before posting back-to-school photos online.
For more, we're joined by AFP Commander Helen Schneider. Commander, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Look,
I find this really difficult to take, this news. Have we really come to this?
Well, it's just a timely reminder as we head back to school to think about when parents and carers are taking these milestone snaps to make sure it doesn't contain inadvertent information that is personal, and if they're sharing them, just be mindful of who can access those images.
Well, who is it that you are concerned about that's accessing these images, and what are they doing with that information?
Well, the AFP leads the Australian Centre to Counter Child Exploitation, and unfortunately at the centre we have seen examples where we do see individuals using these kind of really innocent images to groom our children and profile our children, and of course we have found, unfortunately, these images in collections of child abuse material that we've seized. Mm. I don't say this to scare people, but it's just about making sure parents and carers, you know, put measures in place to prevent this kind of thing from happening in the first place.
Oh, I find it scarier than that, many pedos out there.
Yeah, it will scare people.
It's not common, but it does happen. So it's important as we head back to school, and it's important to capture these milestones, that we just put simple steps in place, particularly around our privacy settings.
Talk us through those.
Well, we encourage a bit of homework for parents, some privacy check-ins, and that's making sure your social media apps are set to private or friend-only, and your devices as well. Think about having conversations with other people as well if they're taking photos of your children about how those photos will be used and who will they be shared with. And make sure you're making logos of schools and names of sporting clubs and things like that not available in those images when they're posted. And never, of course, post your child's name or age.
It's tough for schools too, right? I mean, schools use photos of kids all the time. I know they have to get parental permission to do that, but even that is brought into question now.
Yeah, I think it's just about being conscious of when you are sharing and posting images online, is it to people you know and trust? And that's what I guess I'm asking parents and carers to consider, because they absolutely play the most critical role in keeping our children safe online.
Good on you, Commander. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Well, it's back to school for Queensland this morning. Police putting drivers on notice to keep kids safe. Joining us now is Assistant Commissioner from Brisbane. What's your message to motorists this morning?
So, yeah, you're right. It's back to work for a lot of people, back to school, but we're also back to those reduced speed limits in and around schools, those 40-kilometre zones between 7 and 9 and 2 and 4, but also some campuses limits all day, in particular where we see a campus split by a road. So we urge parents to be safe around those schools. We understand that families are going to be absolutely under the pump this morning. A lot of extra people going to school because it's the first day of prep or first day of grade one. So we need to be thinking ahead for those junior school attenders who won't be thinking about road safety.
Why is an increase in police officers so important at this time of the year?
Well, as I said, we see those increased traffic around schools, in and around schools, particularly the first week of school. A lot of parents dropping kids off for the first time. Preppies, first day at school, so a lot of parents attending for that. So, and as I said, what we see with those junior school users, in particular those on foot, on their scooters, on their push bikes, you know, they're not necessarily thinking about the road rules, thinking about seeing friends again and that type of activity. So we need to be making decisions and thinking about road safety for them as well.
Okay, thank you for being with us this morning, Assistant Commissioner Chris Stream in Brisbane, for that update.